You can't talk about material culture in America without talking about glass. Across the culture, our entire country, it's a significant part of our story. But then you come back to West Virginia or to the Ohio Valley, and it becomes even dramatically more important. The number of glass factories in West Virginia since the first opened in 1813, 473 glass factories. But the impact has been over two centuries immense. Families have depended on it, communities have depended on it, and our identity at times has been directly tied to it. And industry has moved on to where most things are made on large scale with robotics and other much more complicated things. But somehow there's an importance to talk about things made by hand. There's an importance to talk about artisans who actually make it and, you know, who are invested in each and every single piece. I do think that preserving the art and the craft of glassmaking is important to us as a state, important to us as a country, and important to us as people. What we're doing right now is trying to lay the groundwork to ensure that West Virginia and Blenko have a future. And part of that is to tell the story better. We've got great objects hither and yon, but we don't tell the story. We set the objects out. We're working with a bunch of young West Virginians from around the state, some brilliant young folks, some great young minds, and challenging them to help us tell the story in a way that is appealing to people of their age, that uses technology that is current now, and to be able to project forward with those kind of components. The bigger vision is to make, instead of a museum and a factory tour, to make it one continuous, contiguous piece that starts the past, tells you some story, and then shows you what we're doing right now, and maybe even talks about our future. So, bigger puzzle, bigger pieces, bigger story.